Welcome to this introductory video to the ScrollMate 2 stack for RapidWeaver. ScrollMate has been around for quite a long time and has been a very popular way to animate your content on Scroll. And during that time, I've had a lot of requests for some new features and new ways to use the stack. Well, we've finally got round to it and ScrollMate 2 has arrived with those new features. So what I'm going to do in this video is give you a short overview of how ScrollMate works, what it does, and how the new features fit in to what you already know if you've used it before. So the first thing about ScrollMate is that it gives you a lot of control on where your animations happen on the page. So what we've got here is just a page full of text, just to give us somewhere to scroll. And I'm going to put this ScrollMate in here. And we'll just drop a image into it, just a normal stacks image, just so we've got something that we can see moving. Now you'll notice in the controls for ScrollMate, we've got a few extra ones, but largely they're the same as they were before in ScrollMate 1. And the unique thing about ScrollMate is this top area of the settings. The most obvious ones are the start and end percentage. So this tells us where on the page the animations will start, and there are quite extensive tooltips you just saw pop up there, and when the animation will end. So by default, they start at the bottom of the page at 0 and end at the top of the page at 100. So 0 is when the top edge, you see the trigger is set to top edge up here. When that top edge of this stack reaches the bottom of the page, it first comes into view, that's your start percentage. And then as you scroll up the page, obviously that top gets to the 100% of its scroll range, 100% at the top of the browser, and that will be the end. So we will animate during this period. So if we were to change this to 30 and 70, then the animation would start somewhere. I need to scroll to say about there, it's about 30% of the page, so it would sit there, and about here the animation would start, and somewhere about here, 70% up the browser, it would end. So let's just see that. We're going to animate from or to. We're going to animate to the values that we set, so it's going to start off where we've put it, right in the middle. And we'll say we're going to move the X position, so it's horizontal position, 100. And this is one of the new features. We now have percentages and browser units. So we're going to move it 100%. So 100% is going to be the full width of the ScrollMate stack. Okay, so it's going to be the width of this whole image stack, which is image stacks go full width. So it's not just the image that you can see. Okay, so let's preview that. And you can see now we're going to get to 30%. So the top of this stack is 30% up the screen, and it starts to scroll and it goes off by 100% of its own width. So that's probably a bit much even for this example. So let's just move it a smaller amount. Let's move it back to pixels, and let's move it 500 pixels just for now. So you can now see, there we go. At 30% it starts, and at 70% it's no longer moving anymore. So it's stopped there, okay? If we were wanting to animate it in rather than move it out, we would say we could animate from the settings, okay? So now it's gonna start where we've placed it, 500 pixels over to the right. It's going to start there when it comes in, and then it's going to animate to the settings that are in the stack from the settings that are in ScrollMate. That wasn't very clear, was it? It's going to animate from these settings, from these shift animated settings. So there, 500 pixels over to the right, to the settings of the stack, the default position of the stack where it would be without a ScrollMate. Okay, so that's the setting you'd use if you wanted something to appear. So instead of moving it in the X, let's move it in the Y. So let's say minus 100 in Y. So that's going to move it up. You just saw it move there. And this time we're going to change the opacity to naught. Okay, so when it comes on, it's now got an opacity of naught because we're animating from the settings we're specifying. So we're animating from an opacity of naught and a shift of 100 pixels. And then between 30 and 70%, it goes back to where it belongs. Opacity of 1 and no shift. Okay, so that's just a nice little drop-in type effect. You will also notice with that we now have an inertia. We've always had easing. I don't know whether people really used it that much to affect how the animation related to the actual position on the scroll. One thing people asked a lot about was just having a time on that easing. So that's what we've got now. So you can now see, even if you scroll fast, it just gives it a bit of inertia, gives it a bit of weight. If we put this back to zero, which you want sometimes, then it happens a lot faster. So if we scroll quickly, it happens instantly. So the inertia and the percentages are great. So if we wanted to move something exactly off screen, we could move it by browser units. So if we wanted to move it horizontally, we could move it by 100 browser width units, which is 100% of the screen. So this makes it really easy when we're doing responsive design. Before, we had to sort of overestimate pixels because we needed to account for the biggest possible width of the browser. And it was always, you know, too much for small screens then, and it ruined the animation. So that's a huge, huge change. The other thing that we can do with ScrollMate is we can nest ScrollMates. So there you've got it moving and fading at the same time. Let's just take that opacity off. So we're going to animate from 100% to 100%. Okay. So we can put another ScrollMate around the outside of that. And we can do the animation from settings again. So with this set to the same values as the first stack, it's just how we had it before. They're both going to happen in concert. They're both going to happen together. But the idea of doing this is we can change the timing. So the positioning is going to happen between 30 and 70%, our original scroll mate. This one, let's say we only want the opacity to fade in between 45 and 60. Okay, so the opacity is going to happen faster. It's not going to be a great effect because we're not going to see it as soon, but it'll just demonstrate what I mean. So now the opacity is going to come in there and the scroll is still going on. So you may or may not want to do that, but it's a good way to nest effects. You could, for instance, fly it in from the left. Some of the demo site ones do that. So instead of going from 45 to 60, let's go from naught to 40. Okay, so in this, we're going to still do the opacity, but we'll do a move of, say, 50, so half of the screen width. So now it's going to fly in from the left as well. From the right, even, as well as dropping down. I previewed in browser there, which is why it moved around. So let's try actually making it flying from the left. So minus 50. Okay, so now it's going to fly in from the left and drop down. So you can actually see, if you see it slowly, now it's getting into the drop down. Again, that's not a great effect, but it shows the two different effects at work. Ideally, you would want to time them together. But nesting is a very powerful feature of ScrollMate. Another powerful feature of ScrollMate is the ability to float its content, which is new. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to get rid of that one, and I'm going to bring in the stack that we've got in the demo page. So this is just a couple of columns done with a sidebar. And you can see it's all set up just like it was in the demo. And it just gives a bit of a parallax movement, it just shifts up and down in its column. Now, if we were to take this ScrollMate and change its position to float, so now it's going to be floating in its parent stack in its blueprint. So we won't see too much difference at the moment, except it's gone to the top because it's no longer getting centered by blueprint. Where we will see some difference is, say we had some text in that blueprint. This is not going to look great, but it demonstrates it nicely. So now you can see how the ScrollMate is actually floating in that blueprint over the text. So you could float it over a picture in the background and have different layers. So when we select the float setting in ScrollMate, it's a very quick and convenient way to position it. But you might, for instance, want to move it around a bit. So let's turn the float back off and let's add an advanced positioning child. So this is exactly the same stack that comes with Pro Styles and allows you to advance position Sections Pro and Blueprint. Well, it works with ScrollMate now as well. So make sure that you have Pro Styles updated. And we're gonna say absolute, so we're gonna say relative to parent, so that the ScrollMate is now gonna be relative to the blueprint stack. And this time we've got more control now, so vertical, we can say we're gonna have it 20%, say from the top. Just guessing at these, 20% from the top. Width is going to be the same, but let's offset the width to the right by 20%. Okay, so now it's going to jump out of this blueprint apparently and move over to the right hand side. We're also going to set the Z index to 1 just to make sure it comes to the front. Let's move it a bit further to the right so you can see, there we go. So now it's actually out of the column. So we've got our two columns of our sidebar stack and this is out and it's floating between the two. And you can see here, interestingly, it's in front. We've set our Z index, it's in front of the column that it's in, but it's underneath the next column. Now that's because this is just the next piece of HTML in the page. And as you go down the page, things are on top. So if we wanted to float that in the middle and it to be on top of both pieces of text, all we'd do is we'd move that into that column. And in our advanced positioning, we wouldn't want to float it with an offset to the right by offsetting it from the left. We want to offset it from the right, which would push it to the left. And now it's 40% left of this right hand column and over both of them. We could move it a bit more, we could say 60%, and there you go. So that's how the float works. Very, very simple. And you can do this as many times as you want. You can layer these things up and it's just familiar controls. So let's put this one a lot further over. We're going to move this one over 90%, and we can change its scroll. The first one was going up by 100. Let's make this one go down by 200. So now they're going apart, and you can see how beautifully smooth they are. I'll keep previewing browser. Okay. So even in Rapid Weaver, they're lovely and smooth. When we go to preview in browser, they are buttery. And on mobile as well, it all works and the animations are gorgeously smooth there as well. You can put a lot of ScrollMate stacks on the page without affecting performance. It's an incredibly efficient, low CPU intensive process. But don't, because from a design point of view, it will look overdone. The homepage that we've got here has got a lot of effects on it, lots of things sliding around and moving and parallaxing, and that's to show how it works and to show the possibilities. I don't suggest that you start copying this page, but it just gives an example of what you can do. So you can see the text there moves away as we get to the top, and then we have an overlay on this top section that is fading in as we scroll, so you can see it darkens off the top section with the scroll, bit of a movement on that text, again very subtle, so it just gives a bit of a hint that something's happening. And then we're moving in this SVG behind the stack, the watch has already flown in from the left, and so on and so on. So nice little effect with the boxes there, and all these layers all done with ScrollMate and Blueprint. There's no other stacks on the page, so and Sections Pro at the top, so it makes it very easy to use and very easy to set up. I'm just going to show you one last thing before we go, is now that it works on touch devices, we have these two settings. First setting is for this ScrollMate stack, so the one we're looking at here, this one in this case, no animations on touch devices. So that's sort of like a conventional don't animate on touch. The blue one, blue settings are page-wide settings in Stacks 3. This will turn off animation on touch devices on every ScrollMate on the page. So if you enable that, you will stop it for everything on the page, no matter how many you've got, with one setting. And if we go to this ScrollMate, you'll see it's switched on there. If I switch it off in that ScrollMate stack and come back to this one, it's off here as well. So these blue settings are page-wide. So it makes it just really easy. If you don't want it on touch devices, just turn it off there. Well, I hope that's been useful, and we'll have some more ScrollMate information in the future coming up soon. Thanks for listening. Bye.